Retrospect. If you're not familiar with the term, retrospect is defined as a contemplation of the past, a survey of past time events, etc. I believe that our greatest strengths, quite honestly, are found in retrospect, because we go through so many things in life, be it personal issues, professional issues, spiritual issues. There's so many different things, but when we look back, I know me personally, when I look back at my life, and, you know, going all the way back to, you know, my mom and my dad separating when I was a little kid, at the time it seemed like such a horrible thing, and watching my mother, you know, one of the few times in my life that I actually saw her cry, and how that just absolutely devastated me even as a child. But when I look back at that now, I understand that, you know, she picked herself up and she became stronger through that. You know, she raised me and my brother by herself. She never complained. And I think she truly understood that in retrospect, you can look back and see that the tough times are what actually make us stronger. You know, we can't gain strength. We can't get stronger if life is easy. You know, it's the difficult times that we don't know if we're ever going to make it through. And at the time, we're like, you know, just, oh my God, you know. You know, I guess initially, a lot of people's reactions is, you know, why me, God? Why is this happening to me? But when you really look at it, I believe that God allows us to go through these different things to help us become stronger, you know, so that we can, once we've gone through it, we can look back and say, man, I made it through that. You know, I can make it through anything. You know, so the next thing in life that maybe is, you know, kind of pales in comparison to what you've been through before, you can really look at things and say, I did it before, you know, I can do it again. And that's really what my mother embodied, in the sense that she always taught me to look for the positive in everything. And, you know, sure, there's negative out there. Sure, if you look for it, you're going to find negative. But I was raised and I was taught that you look for the positive. Look for the positive in events. Look for the positive in people. And, you know, quite honestly, in retrospect, some of the most difficult people that I've met in my life, and, you know, maybe I was difficult to them as well, but the most disgruntled or difficult people that I've met in my life are always been the kind of people that I've been drawn to, because, you know, I know there's something good there. You know, Mom taught me that. You know, I know if you take the time and get to know somebody, and I've always been intrigued by, why is somebody upset? Why is somebody disgruntled with life, you know? And I always want to dig below the surface. I want to find out, you know, why, you know? And quite honestly, most of the people like that I've come across in my life have become some of my closest friends. And, you know, we actually took the time to get to know each other and open up about things. And I learned a lot about myself and learned a lot about other people and things that they've been through. And I think sometimes it's just the fact that, you know, people weren't as blessed as I was to be raised by somebody that taught me to look back and reflect on my life and become stronger from those times. You know, they were people that maybe were in a negative environment, and, you know, they didn't have somebody to teach them to look for that silver lining, you know, to teach them to say, hey, you know, there's good here. There's strength that can be found here and built here. So, you know, God's allowed me to, I don't know what the proper word is, but, you know, pass on the words that my mother gave me, pass on the lessons that my mother taught me about looking for the good in situations. And like I say, some of the most disgruntled people that I've met in my life have become my closest friends. And quite honestly, I mean close, I mean like brothers and sisters. And, you know, those of you that are reading this or listening to this understand exactly who you are and what we mean to each other, you know. And but like I say, retrospect is such a powerful thing, because I, you know, go back to your, you know, we've all had our first romantic breakup as a you know, as a teenager or whatever, and how we thought it was so devastating that we would never get through it. And, you know, and then in time we learned that, you know, once again, those are things that are God's allowing us to go through so that we can become stronger, so that we can, you know, the next, we learn from these things. We look back and take ownership and understand the roles that we play in all this, and that we're not victims. You know, you can choose to be a victim, but I refuse that. My mother would never allow that. You know, you have to take ownership of your part that you played in anything, no matter how minute it is. You have to take ownership of that and understand and grow stronger from that. So maybe the next time you're in the same situation, you know, you can have a little bit better perspective on what's going on and what you did last time, and avoid doing that again. You know, some things can't be avoided, but I think there are very, very few things in this world that can't be avoided. You know, it's all about how we want to react to it and how we want to respond to situations and people. And because quite honestly, it's our decision. You know, you get up every day and you can be upset or you can be happy. That's a decision you make. Nobody else can put that on you. But I can say, back on the subject of retrospect, is so incredibly powerful, because, you know, I think about as a child, I know I've, those of you that have talked with me or read anything that I wrote, I've gone on and on about my brain aneurysm that I had when I was 10 years old. And, you know, more than me, I can only imagine what it was like for my mother, you know, raising two young boys. And she's a single mother with no child support. But like I say, her faith and strength was beyond words, quite honestly. You know, and a strength and faith that only can be found in God. You know, because without God, I don't know how she would have done it. But, you know, to be able to have to go to work every day and to put food on the table, but understanding that, you know, if she came home that evening, I might not be alive. You know, if it popped again in between the two surgeries, I wouldn't be alive. You know, but she did it. And she did that on faith. You know, that's true faith. It's not talking the talk. It's not, oh, look at me. That's walking the walk, man. And I think that's what life is all about. And but I look back at that and I think of that, and I gain so much strength from that now. You know, at 51 years old, I look back and say, dude, God let you survive a brain aneurysm. I mean, what are the odds of that? I don't know. I think I looked it up on the internet one time, and it was like 85% of people who have a brain aneurysm that bursts die. You know, the survival rate is next to nothing. And then when you think about the fact that my aneurysm burst in the evening when I was at football practice, and Mom didn't get me to the hospital until the next morning, because at the time, you know, it was before you ran to the hospital for everything, she thought I had the flu. So I was at home in bed all night with that. And I remember how excruciating the pain was, you know, at the time. But I remember telling Mom, you know, Mom, I can't take this anymore. And that next morning, she took me to the doctor, and we went in, and they looked at my eyes and sent me right to the hospital. And next thing you know, I was getting a spinal tap and angiogram, and they saw what was going on. And next thing you know, here's this 10-year-old kid in the hospital going through brain surgery, you know, and a single mother raising us both. But, you know, so we go through all that, and the biggest thing that I gain from that is, you know, the strength that my mother had and the faith that my mother had. But I also understood that, you know, God kept me around here for a reason. You know, God let me survive that for a reason. And I do believe that it's because he knew the strength that I was gaining. He knew the empathy that I would be able to have in my life from those experiences, you know, to understand. And I truly understand it's not about me. It really isn't. It's about God's will and God's plan. You know, God uses us all, you know, as, what do you want to call it, you know, soldiers, disciples, to, you know, to share our testimony, to share our experiences, our hard times with other people, because there's a lot of people walking around in this world that are going through hard times. I think they're the only ones that are going through the hard times. And those are the people that get in a lot of trouble, you know, and depression wise or whatever they may do, you know, maybe people trying to commit suicide or whatever. But if we're willing to step out of the shadows, those of us that have been through these things, and share our stories and share our experiences and say, brother, you know, or sister, I've been there, man. I understand where you're coming from. You know, and share the story that, hey, you know, I had this health issue at 10 years old, or, you know, I went through this breakup in a relationship, and or anything that you want to look at, you know. All the hard times, you know, the hard times are what make us stronger. And if we can share those stories, you know, where you can look somebody in the eye and they look you in the eye, and, you know, it's that feeling of, wow, you too, you know, I'm not in this by myself. You truly do understand what I'm going through. And then, you know, you can form that bond and you can help each other. And, you know, that's what we're here for. You know, God puts us or allows us to go through these different situations, I truly believe, for just that reason, you know, to help make somebody else stronger. You know, I can look back at being a little kid, second grade, I think, and, you know, my mother and father getting a divorce and us having to move out of town and literally move out to where we had to hide away from my father. And, you know, but we became stronger through all that, you know, me, mom, and my brother, and grandma too. You throw her in the mix, you know, there was no boo-hoo and there was no pity parties. There was, you know, we learned from all that. In retrospect, mom made us so much stronger. Mom could have allowed us to be victims and be upset with the world and cry and whine and say, you know, I'm never going to have anything. But quite the opposite, you know, she made sure that we understood that, you know, every day is a gift. You know, just waking up is a gift. You know, this cancer that I'm going through right now. Yeah, stage 4 cancer, boy, that stings. You know, the bilateral nephrostomy bags that I have in my kidneys right now. That stings. But you know what? You got to look at the other options. You know, I could die. That would stink. I could have went through kidney failure, you know, but I didn't, you know. I was blessed with, shout out to the City of Hope and my personal doctor, that, you know, they were there. They care about me. They love my family, my friends, my family, all the people that are just, quite honestly, overwhelmed me with the love for my family and for me, and the caring and the kind words. Those are the things that really choke me up, because, man, it's overwhelming. You know, I knew I was loved. I know people cared about me, but to the depth that they really do, I quite honestly, I had no idea. You know, but once again, these are all things that I look at as, it's a tough time now, but I'm going to come through this stronger. My family's going to come through this stronger. You know, me, my wife, and my son, we all stand on faith because we know God's going to take care of this. You know, and we've asked that God use us. You know, we've asked that God allow us to have a testimony to share with everybody when this is, you know, going on and when it's over with. And, you know, people look at us and say, man, how can you be so positive, you know, through stage 4 cancer, and they can't remove it, and you're going through chemotherapy, and you got these, you know, bags in your, or these tubes in your kidneys, and, you know, all this hormone. How can you go through that? And I just say, man, because God, you know, He's in charge. You know, this is, He's gonna handle this, and one way or another, He's gonna handle this. And quite honestly, I'm not gonna lie. You know, I believe this is what God put me on this earth for. This is why I'm here right now. What's going on right now? Because I want to share this with people. I want to, not to say, boo-hoo, look at me, I got cancer. What I want to say is, you know, God is good. You know, and He's going to use my faith that my mother instilled in me to make other people's faith stronger. You know, I'm not one for shoving anything down anybody's throat. I'm not going to sit here and tell you I'm right and you're wrong. But what I am going to do is, I'm going to show you how I live my life. I'm going to show you that I have faith. I have true faith. I'm going to show you that I'm not laying awake at night worrying about this. I'm not, you know, on my knees pleading to God, why me, why me? You know, because quite honestly, my feeling is, why not me? You know, I'm no different than anybody else. And God built me for this, you know. I went through these things when I was a child. All these different experiences. I had a mother that taught me about faith. She taught me how to be strong. And that's, you know, God used that to build me to where I am now. You know, this isn't about me. This is about His faith. This is about His strength. This is about my belief in Him, and that is what His ultimate goal is, you know. And so in retrospect, I look back at, you know, what Mom went through, you know, with a 10-year-old boy going through all that. And, you know, here I am now at 51. I can handle this. You know, quite honestly, if the good Lord decided to take me tomorrow, I know where I'm going. So say what you want to say. I'm not worried about that. But at the same point, you know, I'm not throwing in the towel. You know, there's a lot of fighting this old dog. I'm going to keep pushing. I'm going to do what God asks. I'm going to do what the doctors ask, because I know that I have doctors that care about me, doctors that love me. And in retrospect, you know, I'm going to be able to look back at this and say, that's one more thing that God allowed me to go through. And that's one more thing that I'm going to be able to sit down with somebody and share my story and share my experience. You know, maybe somebody that doesn't have faith, that doesn't have hope, that I can sit down and look them in the eye, you know, and once again, you know, come to that, man, me too. I've been there. I get where you're coming from, and this is going to be okay. You know, life's incredible. It's as good as you want it to be, or it's as bad as you want it to be. Quite honestly, in a nutshell, I firmly believe that. I know this, I've said it time and again, but this isn't about me. You know, this is about faith. This is about believing. This is about walking the walk. This is about, you know, retrospect, looking back and understanding what I've been through and those around me, what they've been through, and the strength that we've gathered and the faith that we've built. You know, I ask, my prayer every night is, you know, God, give me and my wife and my son the physical, mental, and spiritual strength that we need to get through this. And give us the strength to accept your will and understand that, you know, when you lay yourself out there and you say, God, use me, that it doesn't always turn out exactly the way you want it to be. But it's not about what I want it to be. Like I said before, this isn't about me. What it is about is however God wants to use you, whatever that may be. You know, whether I make it through this or I don't make it through this, bottom line is, you know, God's got our days marked. You know, it's an old saying, but I firmly believe it is, you know, we're all living, but we're also all dying. You know, from the day you're born, you're dying. The clock's ticking. You know, so you, maybe that sounds a little negative, but it's the honesty. And the reason I say that is because I think it's important that we understand that tomorrow's not promised to anybody. You know, we don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. I don't know what's going to happen 30 minutes from now. I'm out on a walk right now, and, you know, my plan is to be back at the house in about 20 minutes, but I don't know. That's in God's hands. So what I want to do is I want to appreciate each day, each minute, each second. I want to appreciate the people in my life. I want to appreciate my friends, my family. And I want everybody to know how important they are, how many people that have touched my life and made me stronger. You know, it's one of my goals is to recontact people in my life that I haven't seen in a long time or talked to in a long time, so that they can truly understand how important they are to me and the role that they played in helping to make me into the man that I am today. That, you know, we're all pieces of all the different people we've come across in our life, good or bad. you know, some of the negative people or negative incidents in my life, you know, to roll all the way back to what I was initially talking to or talking about. Those are the times that made me the strongest, you know. God rest my father's soul. I love him. But he wasn't much of a father when I was growing up. But through that experience, I learned how important it was to be a good father. I learned how important it was to be there for Brody. You know, and to be the best father that I could be. And by no means was I a perfect father, or am I a perfect father. But I look at my life as, you know, my true purpose here is to do God's will, and to be the best husband and the best father that I can be, the best friend that I can be. And I try to make, you know, put Brody and Vicky at the top of every decision that I make, to ultimately understand how it's going to affect them. But what I'm saying is, these negative things that we think are happening in our life, these terrible times that we think that we're going through, you know, what I ask you is, don't look at it that way. You know, step back and enjoy, as crazy as that sounds, appreciate maybe is a better word, of what you're going through, what God's allowing you to go through right now. Be strong. Have faith. Because, you know, he hasn't given you anything yet that you can't handle. Because here we are. Here I am, you know, going for my walk. And it's all about retrospect. It's all about looking back and understanding that these times are going to make us stronger. What I'm going through right now is going to make me stronger. It's going to make my wife stronger. It's going to make my son stronger. My nephews, my nieces. Kids that I coach in football. They're all going to gain strength from this, you know, because hopefully someday they can look back in retrospect. The same way that I look back in retrospect on what my mother taught me. And maybe somebody in some future generation, maybe even three generations from now, is going to be able to sit back and say, well, let me tell you about Uncle Mitch, or let me tell you about your grandfather or your great-grandfather or whatever it may be, and what he taught me. The same way that my mom taught me, the same gift that God instilled in my mother, which she gave to me and my brother, I want to be able to share that. I want to pass that on. I don't want that gift to die with mom or with me. So, you know, to wrap things up, all comes back to retrospect, man. Look at your life. Enjoy all the beauty in your life. Enjoy everything. Enjoy it. You know, soak it in. Understand, you know, we get one go round. There's no practice run. This is it. Life is the real deal. So I ask that you be positive. I ask that you understand. I ask that, you know, if you don't have faith, you know, find faith. Understand that it's bigger than you. You know, if you live a self-centered life, and these are the times that are hard to go through, you know, because you can't understand, you get caught in that why me, and like I said before, quite honestly, why not me? You know, God built me for this. I want to be a warrior for God. I want to be somebody that's walked the walk. You know, and I do not claim to be perfect. God knows the things that I've been through and the places that I've been. But I do know who I am right now. I do know that God has me on this path for a reason. I do know that God is using me to have a testimony to share with somebody else somewhere down the road, and to help make somebody else stronger, to help somebody else find their faith, you know, to help somebody else understand that what our true purpose is. You know, like I say, retrospect. That's what I ask. Look back at your life. If you've been spending a life as a victim, give that up, dude. Forget about the victim. Be stronger. Don't use those experiences as a crutch. Use them as motivation to move forward, to be better, to be stronger, you know, to gain strength. Understand, you know, we grow through the tough times. You know, it's through the valley that we gain our strength. You know, when we get to the mountaintop, That's just where we look out and look for the next mountain to climb. You know, so understand the tough times, the hard times. These are the times that make us stronger. Retrospect. This is Mitch Speed. Be blessed.